Hey guys, what is up? Welcome into my channel for today's video. One of my most highly requested, literally for the last year. I'm going to be ranking all of my Pat McGrath palettes from my least to my most favorite. So if you want to see what comes out on top, then just keep watching. Hi guys, if you're new here, my name is Morgan. I am a product knowledge enthusiast. I just love knowing anything and everything about all of the new makeup on the market and sharing my thoughts with you guys. One of my most asked questions is always about Pat McGrath palettes. So a couple of years ago, I came out with a ranking all of my Pat McGrath palettes. A lot of palettes have come out since then, obviously, so I am doing my updated rankings. I don't know if the Pat McGrath sale is going to still currently be going. I'm filming this on Friday, Black Friday, so hopefully it's still here the day that I upload it. If not, I'm very, very sorry. I hope that this is still a helpful resource for you. I did change up my location. I'm in the middle of creating a glam room. I moved rooms in the house and I have a room dedicated to my makeup, and I'll have a video for that soon, probably in the next couple of weeks as I do the finishing touches. Anywho, I decided to only talk about my palettes that are still available to purchase for you guys. You guys always tell me you use this video as a resource to help you pick out which palette you should purchase. So I wanted to make sure I was only sharing with you palettes that you can get your hands on. I currently have a total of 16 Pat McGrath palettes that are on sale right now. Let's get into it. We'll start off with number 16. And unfortunately, this is from one of the newest holiday collections. This is the Celestial Divinity Luxe Squad in Flare Fantasy. Now, if you're new to my channel, Pat McGrath is my favorite brand when it comes to eyeshadow palettes. So really none of her palettes I'm going to share with you today are bad. This is the only one I would say that I really am kind of disappointed in. For me, it's just not a color story that I find myself wanting to gravitate towards. I find it to be just very light, kind of lacking depth. I think this will be really gorgeous in the springtime, but for it coming out over the holiday season, this is not a palette I want to grab for at all. It's really, really light on the eyes. I don't think it's going to work very well on deeper complexions, and even on me, I just wanted more from it. When I think of Pat McGrath, I don't want to do a natural look, and I feel like you get a really soft finish to the eye with this, and it's just not what I want when I reach for Pat McGrath. Do I think it's a bad palette? No, I think it is a very nice palette still. It's just not what I'm looking for when it comes to a Pat McGrath palette. So that's why it is currently my least favorite. Moving on to number 15. This came out in the holiday collection last year. It is still available on the website. This is the Blitz Astral Quad in Iconic Illumination, and this is so stunning. From this point on, I really, really enjoy the palettes that I'm sharing with you guys. Really gorgeous neutral tones. I love the Blitz Astral Quads that came out last year more than the quads that came out this year because I just like this formula a lot better. I just don't find myself reaching for this a ton because, again, those neutral tones. When I want a color look, I'm going for the colorful palettes when it comes to Pat McGrath. I love the quality in here. This is an amazing deep chocolate brown. They have an amazing special formula here. All around, a really great quad. And if you're into neutral tones in a great Pat McGrath formula, I do highly recommend this one. Moving on to number 14, we have a quad again from the holiday collection this year. This is the Risqué Rose. I love the packaging, and I actually really, really did like this one. I found that it just wasn't one that I wanted to reach for. The only color that I'm really amazed by is lavendering right here. I think it's one of Pat's best. I just love it. It's so unique. But the other colors in here, I feel like, aren't quite so unique. I feel like I have these colors in a billion other Pat palettes, so I don't feel the need to reach for this quad a lot, except for lavendering. I would reach for this quad for lavendering alone, but everything else about this quad, quality is great, but I'm just not necessarily impressed by the color story. Moving on to number 13, we have a Mothership palette. I guess she hasn't really come out with too many Mothership palettes. This is the only one I believe that she currently even has on her website because she's come out with a lot of these, but this is the Rose Decadence. It's really a gorgeous palette. I don't think the quality in here is the greatest. These shadows felt a lot more dry to me compared to the others. I love the color story here. I think it's stunning, but Pat, you'll see as this video goes on, she has a lot of different rose palettes and I prefer those. So that's why this is kind of on the lower end. You know, if this was the only Pat McGrath palette that had come out, she didn't have all the other stuff, I would say this is a really gorgeous palette. But just compared to what she's come out with, it's It's not that great, honestly. I'm very surprised. I still think it's wonderful quality. I love the color story. It's just not unique in her line, and I just feel like you should grab for other palettes. But it is a great way to get rose colors in this formula in a smaller palette, so I still do like this one. Moving on to number 12, we have the Decadence palette. This is an older palette from her. For a while, this was nearly impossible to get a hold of. This has a very interesting story. This was on sale when it first launched for a very long time. I honestly believe it couldn't sell it. And then as soon as it sold out, people were like, well, I want to buy that now. It was in stock, out of stock, restocked for the longest time. And as far as I can tell, it is currently still available, which is awesome. This isn't my favorite Mothership palette because it doesn't have her special glittery shades. All of her big 10 pan Mothership palettes has a glitter formula except for this one. So I think the formulas in here are extremely creamy. These aren't necessarily colors that I reach for a lot. I just think it's a bit too deep and grungy, smoky for what I typically wear or the looks that I typically go for. The quality is really great. It's a very interesting mix of colors. I do find it to be very, very unique. She's not my favorite. She's got other good ones, in my opinion, but it's still stunning if you love the color story. Moving on to number 11, I think this one is probably gonna shock you guys. It's just not one that I reach for a lot, but it is one of the ones that I recommend to you guys the most, so that's why it might shock you. This is just the original Divine Rose. Now, I got mine in special limited edition packaging. That is why mine is in this gorgeous pink packaging, but I really love this. If you are into neutrals, you're going to love this palette. So if you don't wear a lot of colors, you don't really like to step out of your comfort zone, or maybe, you know, you're just looking for a good work palette, but you want to take Pat McGrath into your collection, this is the one that I recommend you going for. It has very mauvey neutral rose tones in here. Very, very wearable. Probably one of her most wearable palettes in the line, which is why I highly recommend it. I think the formulas in here are very nice. Just again, for me, like I said, I like going a little bit crazy when I'm going for Pat McGrath. So for me, this one isn't my favorite, but you know, the quality is really great, and I think the color story is very versatile for a lot of people. So I highly recommend that if you love neutrals. Moving on to number 10, this is from her very, very first launch when she launched her original three Mothership palettes. So this is called the Sublime palette, and I just don't find myself reaching for this palette a lot. So you'll see as we get into these big Motherships, we have four glitters here. That's just what the Decadence didn't have. And I really like this one. I think the color story is beautiful, but when I looked at all the other color stories I had from her, I just liked them better. Nothing against this palette. I think it's really great. When you cover these four shades, you'll see how wearable this palette is. I don't know. I just think she has prettier color stories. Moving on to number 9, we have a Blitz Astral Quad. Again, another one of those great launches from last year where you get four beautiful formulas from Pat McGrath. So Ritualistic Rose. Oh my gosh, this is so stunning. I do love pinky tones. This has a gorgeous gold tone, two different tones of pinks. This one is really gorgeous, very, very glittery. And then you have a brown. I love this. I used this for a while every day last year, and it is so stunning. I highly recommend you pick this up before they no longer sell it, just because I think it's a great everyday palette, but you get that Pat McGrath look on your eyes. You're super glittery, very easy to apply. Just a look I feel like you cannot replicate with another formula. Moving on to number 8. This is one from this year's holiday collection. This is my favorite of the quads. This is Interstellar Icon. I just find myself wanting to reach for this. It's a little bit more deep and grungy than what I'm used to reaching for, but genuinely it's so good and it's so pretty on the eyes. I feel like every time I wear this palette, I am feeling myself. Of course, I'm definitely going for a more crazy look when I dig for this palette, but I am telling you all, it is so stunning. 10 out of 10 recommend. Moving on to number 7. This is going to be my last quads, and I know a lot of the Motherships 10 pans I haven't spoken of. That's because they're so amazing. They're at the top. But this is the, what's this one called exactly? This is the Nocturnal Nirvana that came out last year. This one is so, so special. I mean, it's a very interesting mix of colors, but I just love popping one of these lid shades on all over my lids after I've done my crease colors. You can actually create a really cool look if you just use these four shades. I honestly remember creating one of my favorite looks I've ever done using just all four shades in this palette. I think it's such an interesting mix of colors. They're not alike, but they blend in green so well together. If you think of color theory, yellow to green to blue to purple, it really does have a cohesive flow to it while still being four very, very different colors. Love the formula here. I just think, again, before this sells out, this is such a fun one to own from Pat. All right, let's move on to number six. We have the Midnight Sun palette. It comes in this gorgeous purple packaging, and let's take a look on the inside. So I have two shades in here that are gonna fall out, these two right here, but this is an interesting color story. This is actually the palette that I chose to wear today because I don't reach for this one a lot, and I don't know why, I just don't. So I did a pretty neutral look as far as Pat McGrath goes, and this guy is the star of the show. This is really what is giving me that stunning bronze copper glow to the eyelid. This palette, I think, is wonderful for deeper complexions. You have a lot of really great warm neutrals here on this side. You have a great olive tone here, a great shimmer, glitter color, a light gold, and you have a fun pop of purple as well. I don't think this purple is the greatest quality when it comes to Pat. I feel like she has such smooth, pigmented formula. This one feels a little bit dry, and it doesn't quite give me the oomph that I want, but I think it's just a really great, easy palette to go for. If you're into those deeper, warm, smoky eyes, I really think you're gonna love this. This is a really fabulous palette for the fall and winter time because of the tones in here. So I think it's really great. It's just not the one that I reach for the most. Moving on to number five, the palette that I was completely shocked by, and I've talked about it so many times recently on my channel. This is the Celestial Divinity palette, a palette like Pat has never done before as far as the format goes. You get 18 shades in here. None are her special glittery shades, but I feel like the value of this was really great. It was under $100 for 18 shades, and if you compare that to some of the other values that she has to offer, this one truly is the best, and I really feel like she didn't skimp on quality here. With the exception of not having her glitter shades, she had every other formula in here. Extremely creamy. I've loved every single look I've created with this palette. This palette really does inspire me as far as the color stories go. I don't know. It's like currently a palette that I have to put away in my makeup collection, so I stopped grabbing for it. So that's when I know it truly is a favorite of mine. Let's move on to number four, and I'm very, very surprised at how high this ended up ranking. But again, it was a palette that I found myself constantly reaching for, and this is the Divine Rose 2. Now, since I wasn't in love with the first Divine Rose, I wasn't very excited for this palette just because I was just like, another rose palette, but I love this guy. Again, I have limited edition packaging, but this color story to me is insane. I think the quality is impeccable. I really was surprised at how often I reached for it. I love actually using this shade as a blush and this shade as a highlighter. They look stunning on the cheeks, and the rest of the shades, they're scrumptious. If you like pinky rose colors, you're really going to enjoy this one a lot. Like I said, I was not excited about it, and it's one of my favorites. Now, if you're more of a neutral wearer, no. You will not like this. Make sure you go for the original Divine Rose palette. But if you like a little bit of color, we have a multi-chrome in this palette. This one is awesome. One of my favorites. Let's go on to number three. And this palette, I think, is very underloved. It does not get the attention that it deserves from people. But this palette is one of my favorites. It is the Subliminal palette. This is from her original launch, and it looks so boring, but I promise you, on the eyes, it is incredible. Now, I think the reason why I love it so much, and I've always loved it, is because it clearly is a very cool tone palette. I love this before I knew I loved cool tones, and the reason I kept reaching for this palette was because it was those cool tones that I love. I feel like you pop any of these shades in the crease, and then you pop any of these shades on the lid, and you're going to be in love with the look that you create. It's a great work palette if you're into more neutral tones, and then you also have these really fun nighttime pops. So office, these top six, and then at the end of the night, just pop one of these and you're good to go. Truly incredible. They layer beautifully over these shades, particularly the black. I find these three shades look stunning over this black shade. So if you're looking for a really unique smoky eye, this palette amazing. Over to number two. This was my favorite palette last year. This was my number one. So I know you guys can't believe it's been demoted. So this is the Bronze Seduction palette, and this is the number one palette that I recommend to anybody wanting a Pat McGrath palette. That was what I said in my last video 2 years ago, and I still stand by that. I love this palette. I love the color story in here. It is absolutely incredible. Great warm tone neutrals here for every day, and then you also have a really cool glittery pink, and just everything about this palette. I feel like it has every single tone that I love, and the glitters in here I think are very, very special. They look so unique on the eyelid. I love that there's a plum in here. You get some browns as well. I just feel very comfortable with this palette. If there's a look that I'm not sure what I want to create, but I want it to be a Pat palette, normally this is the guy that I dig into. So as far as an everyday palette for me, this is the one that I would go to for Pat McGrath. It's not a wearable palette. It can certainly be made wearable, but if you love makeup, you love experimenting with makeup, but maybe you're not, you know, into a rainbow eye, I think this one is great for everybody. Definitely my number one recommendation if you are looking to dive into Pat McGrath for the first time as well. And let's move on to number one, and I know you guys are probably shocked, but yeah, this did not rank at number one 2 years ago when I also still had this palette. But for some reason in the last year, I have felt continually inspired by this palette. There's so many looks that I still want to create with this palette, and I think the more that I've gotten into this YouTube world and experimenting with makeup and seeing what I can create for you guys, the more this palette has come in handy for me. So it's not my number one recommendation for everybody, but to me, this is such a unique palette, and it inspires me to create different looks, and that's what I tend to look for the most in a lot of palettes. This is the Mothership 3 Subversive palette. I just love the color story of this. I think it is a daring color story while still not being too intimidating. You have greens, purples, golds, you have a sheer highlight color, you have a glittery black, a shimmery plum, and then you have some gray basic neutrals as well. I just think you can't go wrong with this palette when it comes to a different, unique kind of smoky eye. Put the brown in your crease, the black in your outer corner, any of these six shades all over the lid, and you look like a professional makeup artist. You look like you know what you're doing with your makeup. While I don't think this is for everybody, it is a color story that I find to be extremely unique. It's one of those palettes where every single look I create with this palette, I am obsessed with. This definitely, in the last year, has been promoted to number one because every time I've used it, I've fallen more and more in love with it to the point where I'm like, you know what? This is just my favorite. I love it. All right, you guys. So that is all I have for this year's rankings of my current Pat McGrath palettes. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I really, really do hope you guys found it helpful. If you aren't subscribed to my channel already, I would absolutely love it if you would consider taking the time to do so. Yes, Natasha Denona is next, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye, guys. Have a good one.